in 3 months, hitting a fresh record high of $3.5 trillion. Now, the big drivers that month, more student loan debt and more charging on credit cards. A weaker than forecast January jobs report sending stocks sharply lower today. The Dow fell 211 points. The tech-heavy NASDAQ down 146. Shares of LinkedIn, the biggest decliner, falling 44% after weak earnings and a weaker outlook. Employers added just 151,000 new workers last month. That was far short of estimates, with education, retail, and transportation losing workers. The good news, though, wages edged a little higher, and the national unemployment rate notched lower to an 8-year low of just 4.9%. And for the first time ever, Apple says it will accept banged-up iPhones as trade-ins if you want to upgrade to a new one. Tom Busby, CNBC.
Ace has the lighting options you want and the answers you need. Right now, four packs of Fight Warm White 60-watt LED bulbs are just $10.99 each after $12 instant savings. Stop by your neighborhood Ace today and save over 50% on four packs of our longest-lasting LED bulbs, now just $10.99 each.
Ace is the place with the helpful hardware, folks.
Ace Rewards members get savings instantly in-store. Offer valid on SKU 3516317, now through 229 at participating stores. Store stock only. See store for details.
There are times being a genius would really come in handy.
As your doctor, I'm going to give it to you straight. You have a severe case of gustatory horripilation enuresis, and you need to choose between a cystoplastic volantate treatment or orthostatic muscae surgery. I'll give you a second to think it over, but we'll need an answer right away. It's bad.
But thankfully, you don't need to be a genius to do your own taxes, because TurboTax's Smart Look feature gives you on-screen assistance to help answer your questions so you're never on your own. Intuit TurboTax. Taxes done smarter. Feature availability varies by product and platform.
Hey, Joe, yes. Who are you picking for the Super Bowl this weekend?
Cleveland Browns.
Cleveland Browns. They're not in the Super Bowl, Joe.
That's why they invented fantasy football.
It's going to be a party this afternoon.
3 p.m. Be listening here on KCAA.
106.5 FM, 1050 AM. It's the Super Bowl happy hour.
Hi, Pat Matthews again. I want to talk to you about selling online. And when I say selling, I'm talking about your home, your car, and even buying a house or a new set of wheels. There's a new kid in town, and that's buysellmakeoffer.com. The revolution has already begun, and I invite you to be a part of it. You see, get in on the ground floor, because buysellmakeoffer.com never charges item fees. Can you imagine what the other guys might charge you for selling a car on their site? Let alone a house. Well, buysellmakeoffer.com doesn't do that. And you can use Skype and YouTube videos to sell your products, big or small. Go right now to buysellmakeoffer.com and set up your account. For as little as $7.95 per month, you can sell up to 50 items. And they'll give you the first 30 days free just to try it out. Remember, no per item fees. Join the revolution today. Buysellmakeoffer.com. And tell them Pat Matthews sent you.
Good afternoon. It is 3:03. I'm Di Rice with the very latest in live local, national, and international news here on KCAA 1050 AM and 106.5 FM. The Republican presidential candidates are starting to prep for the debate tomorrow night ahead of Tuesday's New Hampshire primary. Donald Trump is leading the polls in the Granite State after finishing second to Texas Senator Ted Cruz in this week's Iowa caucuses. Marco Rubio is surging ahead in the latest polls to take the number two spot ahead of Cruz. And a former L.A. area doctor could spend the rest of her life behind bars for the drug overdose deaths of three patients. Lisa Tseng was sentenced today to 30 years to life in prison. It's the first time in California that a doctor was charged with murder for the deaths of patients who were given prescriptions for drugs. And here closer to home, yesterday, detectives arrested Stephen Philip Zoll, 48, of Yucaipa, on suspicion of murdering John Stacy Moore, 46, also of Yucaipa, over 1 year ago at the Melody Land Mobile Home Park. On November 9th of 2014, Moore was found unconscious and unresponsive. He was transported via ambulance from his home to Redlands Community Hospital, where he died the next day. Detectives have since learned that Moore had been assaulting Zoll on numerous occasions before at least one blow took his life. Yesterday, detectives developed information that Zoll was possibly in the Calamasa area He was found and arrested without incident. Detectives are still investigating the circumstances surrounding Moore's death. Inland Empire weather. It is sunny and breezy all weekend long. We are on a progressive warming trend with tomorrow's high about 77 and then Super Bowl Sunday's high about 81. Overnight lows tonight, 46. Currently, it is 72 here in San Bernardino. The perfect temperature, might I add. Checking out your drive through Colton, an accident has cleared the 215 southbound right before La Cadena, but that was due to an earlier car that had flipped, and it has been moved out of lanes, but traffic is still backed up to the 10 freeway, and then the northbound side is also slow from Cactus to La Cadena. Through Loma Linda, accident blocking the left lane, 10 eastbound, right there at Anderson Tippecanoe Avenue. And you have stop-and-go traffic there from the 215. Other than that, through Temecula, accident blocking the left lane 15 southbound at Winchester Road. And through DeVore, the normal stop-and-go from Glen Helen Parkway to Kenwood because of an earlier crash and because it's Friday. And that is the very latest with news, weather, and traffic on the station that leaves no listener behind, KCAA 1050 AM and 106.5 FM.
This is Joe Lyons. Go Red for Women is the American Heart Association's campaign to remind everyone that cardiovascular diseases are the number one killer of women. The good news, 80% of heart disease and strokes can be prevented with lifestyle changes. During Heart Month, schedule a Well Woman checkup to measure your blood pressure, cholesterol, and sugar. Invest an hour of your life to save the rest. For more information, visit goredforwomen.org. That's goredforwomen.org.
KCAA. Wondering what to do on your Friday drive home? Well, the bar is open and it's happy hour. Join us right here on KCAA 1050 AM on Friday at 3 for Trevor's Happy Hour.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, real radio, real fun. It's the Joe and Mark Happy Hour, a show just because it's Friday and because we wanted to have some fun.
It's Friday.
Yes, it is.
Tune in today. We'll be chatting with a few friends, talking about cigars, the Super Bowl, and a little bit about that and a little bit about this, and maybe some music, too.
So, kick back, pour yourself your favorite beverage, and relax, because this is not the time to be serious, because
it's the weekend and it's Friday.
A totally sober show, drunk with fun.
Oh, yes, it is Friday.
Are we alive?
Yes, we are. Wonderful. Yes, we need a little more action on Joe's mic there.
Yeah, I don't hear me in my
there he is,
head
better.
Anymore. Yes.
His wonderful tone.
So if Hoda and Kathy Lee have wine Wednesday, what kind of Friday do we have?
Well, it's going to be cigar Friday.
Cigar Friday? Oh, okay.
That's
well,
right.
I just happen to have, here in my magical little Gurkha box.
By the way, we're going to smoke this for Trevor.
Right.
Because he was smoking something.
There you go.
I don't know.
These are my Super Bowl cigars.
Yeah?
And they
Super
are.
Super Bowl!
They're named for the Gurkhas, the Warriors
hey,
of
Joe,
the 19th century.
Joe,
yes.
It's the Panthers, the Carolina Panthers.
Yes.
And the Broncos.
Right.
Why are you wearing a Cleveland Browns shirt?
Because this is my favorite team. This is the team I'm rooting for on Sunday. This is why they call it...
Everybody get in Joe's football pool because you're guaranteed to win.
Yeah, this is why they call it fantasy football.
This would be the team that comes in third.
Yes, I'm also wearing my hat. Can you identify the character on my hat?
I can identify the character under the hat, but I'm not quite sure if I could see that.
That is the Cleveland Browns brownie. Everybody thinks he's an elf, but he's not. He's the Cleveland Browns brownie. He is the, you know, you think of some of the great sports characters, mascots, or whatever. He's the Cleveland Browns one.
So we're going to be talking about the Super Bowl today. We're going to be talking about a whole bunch of stuff. And we're going to start, we're going to lead in because this is a happy hour. We're going to do something fun with cigars.
Exactly. Here are the Gurkha cigars. You just had the page open in the
Gurkha
the cigar catalog.
That's right. We have the JR, the world's most largest cigar store,
right.
The Gurkha cigars.
Okay. And there are a variety of cigars with the Gurkha logo, the ancient Turkish warrior from the 19th century with his special sword. And they're various heavy-duty. This one will knock you out. This is the Beast. This is the Beauty. This one I like because
Beauty
Exactly. I like a light cigar. This is a what they call a Connecticut Shade wrapper. Very light, very easy smoke. Some people... I once asked one of the better-known cigar makers up at the Big Smoke event in Las Vegas. I said, how do you know when a cigar is too strong? And he said, in my case, it's when you can't stand up. So for all you cigar smokers out there who thought they were kind of wimping out there with the, not being able to enjoy a good cigar, the big ones, if you can't stand up, that's a good cigar.
Oh, okay.
Nothing to be ashamed of.
All right. I got Dave Lehrman on the phone.
Mm-hmm.
And I think we're going to take Dave.
Hey, Mark Westwood.
Hey, how are you doing?
Happy hour. So are we talking cigars today?
We are talking cigars.
Yep.
All right. You know, I've had the pleasure of visiting Cuba on a political student visa.
Mm-hmm.
Is this Joe?
Yes.
Joe Lyons.
Joe, have you ever been to Cuba?
I have not been to Cuba. I wanted to go to one of the Dominican Republic tours, but Cuba, because it's just recently been opened up, haven't gotten in there yet.
I tell you, once you've had a Cuban, you never go back. And I agree, if you're still standing after you smoked a good one, it's not a good one.
Well, you know, the famous Cubans are the Cohibas, which means cigar in Spanish, and they come from the western side of the Cuban island, where the ground is very dark and very earthy, and it extends that flavor into those cigars. So, yeah, if you have to sit down for a while after you've had a good Cohiba.
A good cigar can actually be almost intoxicating, and that's why they're so expensive.
Yeah. In its own way, you're absolutely right. Well, remember, people don't smoke cigars like they smoke cigarettes. They smoke cigarettes because they have to. They smoke cigars.
The addictiveness.
Yeah.
I only date girls who smoke because they're easy to shop for. You buy them a carton of cigarettes, they're happy.
Yeah, buy them a pink lighter or something.
Yeah, exactly.
But, you smoke a cigar because you want to. And it is very – on my really bad days – When Mark is all over me and telling me what he really thinks of me, I can go home and have a good cigar and get it out of my system. And I have to miss Steve Harvey's family feud.
The listeners here must think I'm a beast, you know?
Hey,
which
Mark.
I happen to have
Are you a cigar smoker?
I have smoked about three in my life, but I did. One of them was a Cuban cigar.
Mm-hmm.
So
wasn't that the best of the three?
It was, absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
So you're saying the secret is it's in the growing and the technique as opposed to. It's interesting. Now, domestically, since.
And I will be honest
like
with you.
Me and Jim, here in America, where would you say is the best place to get a good cigar? Is it Carousel Mall?
That was
a joke.
Maybe out on the street you can find a stogie, but
I go to a place over in Rancho Cucamonga called David's Cigars. It's run by a lady named Linda, but she calls the place David's, and that's my favorite place. Although a lot of the stuff I've bought online, and I have it delivered here, as Mark can attest to. Joe, why'd you get a box of Macanudos? Because I can't have them delivered at home. My wife.
God bless the internet.
Absolutely.
But I think the Cuban was the best cigar because I'd smoked two before and finally kind of realized how to enjoy it.
Yeah.
What kind of cigars were they?
Well, the other cigars were just some domestic cigars that my friend had, and I don't really remember. You know, we bought them down at the liquor store kind of a thing.
Yeah.
And by the way, Mark's been advised if the liquor store is selling Chorboys, Brillo, and pipe cleaners, avoid those liquor stores.
That's not a good
those
cigar
are, those
store.
Are not, that, those are not fine wine stores.
It'll say smoke
it's
shop.
It's a bad sign.
Always
the liquor stores with the bulletproof glass like at the banks. Avoid those as well.
Yep.
I guess I'm not going to be going to Willie's down on Mount Vernon.
No.
No more Willie's?
Okay. No more Willie's.
Jim, do you remember Cigar Aficionado magazine?
Oh, yeah, still around.
It is. Now, for a while, you know, cigar culture was really embraced by celebrities, but then political correctness set in, and celebrities... I'm kind of an insider. I'm a gossip guy.
Yeah.
A celebrity still smokes cigars more than anyone, and they get the best from Cuba. In your opinion, what celebrity do you think represents the best poster child for cigars? And I'll let you go with that question and listen to the answer on the air.
Okay.
Thanks, Dave.
Easy answer to that. The celebrity best known associated with cigar smoking, Arnold Schwarzenegger. Only man to be on the cover of Cigar Aficionado.
Well, George Burns, too, for some of the older guys. Well,
a lot of the great comedians had you. If you think of George Burns, if you think of Groucho Marx. thing or
yeah,
no.
So-
You know, lamps for hydroponics and things of that nature, but they don't sell the weed.
Well, now the newspaper article I read in the San Bernardino Sun, by the way, that we're talking about, there might be people who, hey, we're back.
Yes.
There might be people that, give you information or sell it to you online or maybe orders for it there. And there was hundreds of thousands of people.
They're down at the Quickie Mart.
And let me tell you, you could drive by the National Orange Show.
Yeah.
And you get a really good contact high, and that was like, you know,
especially
maybe
if it's upwind from you.
Yeah, maybe on the 10 freeway as you drove way past, you know, by the Inland Center Mall, you're still getting a contact high that day.
Yeah.
It was like, it was the cheapest high you could ever possibly get.
Let's get back to the Super Bowl. Did you know that there is a line in Vegas? There's a line for just about everything in the Super Bowl. Who's going to score the first touchdown? Who's going to throw the first pass? There is a line for Lady Gaga, who's singing the national anthem. How long will she go? It's an over-under at 2 minutes.
Oh, this is the song.
Now, Lady Gaga is an interesting piece of work because she's kind of one of these pop art experience or performance artists. Mm-hmm. A little bit more than Madonna and a little bit less than maybe Yoko. But I've heard her do Gershwin. I've heard her do Cole Porter. We saw her do that incredible Sound of Music medley at the Oscars a couple of years ago.
I'm just waiting for a wardrobe fault. You know, what do they call that?
It would be anticlimactic in Lady Gaga's
malfunction. That's
yeah, a wardrobe malfunction would be anticlimactic because anybody who watched the American Horror Story this year has seen as much of Lady Gaga as anybody is going to.
Lady Gaga is not exactly known for her tatas. Oh, but hey.
wait a minute. Those would be Gaga Tatas.
Anyway, we digress.
Yes.
We're going to talk more about the Super Bowl here in just a minute.
Right.
I don't want to keep our guests here. We have somebody named the Cam Man.
Cam Man.
You mean Mike the Cam Man from Framingham, Massachusetts. That's what everybody that's talking about to the town. This coming Sunday Super Bowl roundup.
Hey.
All right, Mac the Cam Man, how you doing?
Mac the Cam Man.
Yep. I was sick. Go ahead.
What do you have in common with the Patriots?
Huh. Well, anyways, the Patriots who just got get rid of the offensive coordinator. Gone, ancient history. Now we're going to be looking for a new offensive coordinator. They're seeking a good let's see who's definitely top-notch.
Cam, let me tell you what you have in common with the Patriots. You're both going to be watching the Super Bowl on TV.
Tom Brady will have the top 50 Super Bowl's most valuable player as a result.
Yeah, well.
Okay.
Yeah.
Hey, Cam, man, where are you calling from again?
Between Worcester and Boston, we are 20 miles apart. We got 8 inches 6 to 8 inches of snow in Framingham.
Yeah. Oh, wow. Although I understand that Tom Brady was shoveling snow and he's completely deflated now.
No, he's not in. No, he's not in.
We need to. We need a bomb for that joke.
California doing that to Sunday's a blob from the Super Bowl's past MVP. What I want to talk about is one Superman projection. He's going to be dominant from the NFL Super Bowl 50th golden anniversary game.
Yep.
They're the projections that Cam Newton will be outsmart. Repeat, outsmart. The Denver defense, and he'll be dominant when he says.
Okay, now wait a minute. They just said outsmart the Denver defense. Hey, Mike the Cam Man, thanks for calling in.
Yeah.
And we'll have a good Super Bowl with you.
Yeah. Besides, Peyton Manning's wife has been loaning him some of her performance-enhancing drugs. They're not his. She got him in the mail, but he
I got to tell you, folks, you may be a Cleveland fan, but I'm a Broncos fan.
Okay.
Always have been, always will be. Even when the L.A. Lambs left and went to St. Louis with Jorge Frontieri and that woman over there. I'm glad the Rams are back. I really am glad the Rams are back.
But
I'm glad the Chargers are going to be here.
Let me tell you the Cleveland.
Because the Raiders won't be.
Let me tell you the Cleveland perspective on the Rams. They were originally the Cleveland Rams, and they packed up and left us in 1946. They left L.A. to move to Anaheim. They left Anaheim to go to St. Louis, and now they're leaving St. Louis. Anybody wants to root for a gypsy team, they ought to change their name to the Gypsies because you don't know where they're going to be next
year. Well, you know, the Lakers are the Lakers. Why? Because they were
in Minnesota, the land of the 10,000 lakes.
Right. And, you know, these teams move around a little bit.
Yeah.
The Cardinals, the Arizona Cardinals, I still can't get used to that one.
Yeah, well, and the Oakland Athletics who were in Kansas and Philadelphia. It happens.
Right,
but
right.
The Rams are coming back to their records.
Rams are coming back to their home.
They're not coming to Cleveland.
And L.A. needed a home team. L.A. needed a home team. And it's all about the Houston Oilers. Who gave this to me here? Who gave this to me?
I don't know.
Oh, that was Joe Pagano. He's an Oilers fan.
Ah.
Which, by the way, you would not do well in the other part of my family.
Yeah.
Because one part is from Colorado Springs. The other one is from Texas.
Yeah, and the Oilers,
Dallas,
the Oilers are going to be watching TV Sunday, too. So.
Yeah, they're all going to be.
Yeah.
What do we all have in common with them?
We're
all going to be
TV.
Watching TV. What are you going to be doing for the Super Bowl, Joe?
The usual chips and dip.
I'm getting invited the second time to a party.
Yeah.
And I'm coming because I'm coming, folks, the people up there in Yucaipa, at Rachel Gustafson's house, because I'm coming to win that Super Bowl. Pool again.
Uh-huh.
I won it the first time. Walked up there. I was 5 minutes late for the party. They said, we got two things left. I was walking up the driveway. I handed them a $5 bill each for them.
Yep.
And I walked away with the whole big pool. At the end of the night, they were all like, don't ever invite him again.
Yeah. Good to know somebody won.
So this year I got invited back and somebody said, shh, wait a minute. He won the pool last time.
Yeah.
Bubba on the phone, huh? This could be a fun phone call.
Could be.
This could be a fun phone call.
Oh, yes.
All right. Hello?
This is Bubba.
Bubba?
Yeah.
Bubba Shrimp?
And I'm
Bubba
I,
Gump?
I'm here. I
Bubba
mean, look,
Gump?
Look,
yeah.
I have something to say.
You do?
If I got a credit card, you take my money, and this is Bubba.
Oh, that's right. That's
yes.
A credit card guy.
Yeah, absolutely.
Kiss my credit card.
Well, you know.
See, when I make agreements, and one of them was take your post off of Facebook.
In the immortal words of Jim Croce, you took all my money, and it may sound funny, but I come to get my money back.
That's right. That's
right. Don't mess around with Jim.
So let's move on from a losing thing.
Yes.
To a winning thing. Who do you think is going to win the Super Bowl? You want to do a prediction?
Well, you, if you're in the pool.
That's right. I'm looking to be the winner. I'm looking to be a winner anyway.
This is, they used to say, well, I don't have a dog in the fight. But ever since Michael Vick, people don't talk about that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, him and his. Michael Vick, to animal lovers and to Jets fans, is what Hanoi Jane is to an American veteran.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, neither one of them will do anything that supports him. I know dyed-in-the-wool Jets fans who, simply because he played for them for a while, long after the conviction for the animal fights, they still won't support the
it's
Jets.
It's like Pete Rose, you know.
You never forget.
You never forget. These poor guys can't make a mistake ever.
Well, I feel sorry for Pete Rose because all he did was place a bet. He wasn't doing performance-enhancing drugs.
That's right.
He wasn't running dog fights. He didn't do. He wasn't arrested for shooting somebody. He just made a bet.
Yes, that's right. Well, you know, there's lots of things. I'm going to bet on the score before the game begins. This is an old tried and true one. Right. What's the score before it begins? Oh. I can predict it before it begins.
0-0.
0-0, that's right. Anyway. Yeah. But, you know, speaking of money and numbers, who's going to spend the most on Super Bowl Sunday? Do you think it's going to be the Boomers, the Busters? Who? Panthers. Joe says the Panthers, 32-19.
Another Joe. Different Joe.
Joe Pagano. Ah. Joe Pagano in the room. You know, you can get on the microphone, Joe. You don't have to do this. You can get on the microphone.
There's a little there's a little black cat in our neighborhood that is walking around going, I'm a Panther. I'm bad.
Yeah.
And it's a kitten.
Yeah. Okay. So the prediction always is the first person, the first team that scores first in the Super Bowl
right.
wins.
Yeah.
Okay? So I'm going to predict
okay.
the Broncos will score first, and they'll score 3 minutes in.
Okay.
3 minutes in.
On a run or a pass?
It's going to be a pass. It's going to be a pass.
Okay.
It's going to be a pass.
You know, everybody loves a good last 30 seconds Hail Mary pass,
mm-hmm.
but I still love to see the quarterback break through the line and run it in.
Yeah.
You know, I'm old school football.
Well, that Carolina Panthers screen is tough. So, you know,
yeah.
looking at the teams, you're probably going to say they're going to do a pass. They're going to be it's going to be a passing game. That's my other prediction.
Okay.
It's going to be a passing game.
Yeah.
It's got to be a passing game. You know, we got Lyle on the line, and you know, we'll go ahead and take Lyle, how you doing? Lyle Fenimore.
Hey, how's it going there, guys?
Good. How are you?
I'm wonderful. Just
good.
Kicking back, listening to the show and all that good stuff.
Right.
I miss my chair right now, and I'm hoping to be back in it in a couple of weeks.
Well, we hope so, too. We hope so, too.
Yeah. So we're talking Super Bowl and football and all that good stuff right up my alley. You know what? If you don't mind me giving my prediction.
Go.
Sure.
I'm looking for, you know, I'd like to see Peyton, you know, walk away with the second ring, you know, and go off into the sunset and all that good stuff.
Yep.
Just don't see it happening. Yeah, I just I would like for it to happen, but realistically speaking, I think Cam Newton and the Panthers are just going to have their day. And I just overheard you were saying something about, you know, you don't know if they're going to pass, run, or whatever. You know, you think Cam Newton's going to, you know, toss it into the end zone or toss it here or toss it there, and then he'll take off because the kid is a beast. I mean, he's just like he's just a beast.
Yep.
Yeah.
So it's like he can, you know, it takes like three or four defenders to bring him down. So it's. I'm hoping for a good game, but in the end, I really believe Carolina's going to take the cake.
So you don't think it's going to be a passing game? You think it's going to be a running game?
Well, for Carolina or for Denver?
For Carolina, it's definitely going to be probably a running game.
I think it's going to be, you know, like with Peyton, I think he, like in the Super Bowl a couple of years ago, he was behind most of the game. Well, the whole game he was behind. It was just like, you know, just a major blowout with Seattle. And he kept throwing all those underneath passes. So I think he's going to be in a passing mood. I think he's going to be really pass happy.
Yep.
Well, we just got a couple more minutes, Lyle, and we hope you're going to be back. And you know, give me a call and we'll talk it on out. Joe's got something.
Quick
Joe.
Thought before we take the break, and that is this: people are saying the problem with Peyton Manning is he's too old. He's 39. What's that say about you and me?
Oh, don't deflate him there.
Don't deflate him.
No. Don't deflate
what about
him.
Me?
you're not too old. I don't think Peyton is too old, guys. I really don't. I think he's up there in age, and it's time for him, you know, to step down. But as far as, like, being too old to get it done, I don't believe that. I think the guy still has something left in the tank, and I think he wants to showcase it on Sunday. But
we shall see.
For football,
yep.
For football, yeah, it's about that time. But I don't want to use that term, too old.
Thank
you. You know what? If you have a heart and if you really – try, you know, well, and I for one know, because I've done a lot for myself in this last year and a half. So, you know, you have a lot of heart, you know, a lot of soul, you just do your best, and you know, you go for the best.
And there's some skills and maturity, and you think better when you're a little older. You know, if you've in football, I hope you can think better because you've been hit around so much. But yeah, most of the time, that's true.
But then they critique you about, well, his legs aren't holding up, or he doesn't have the arm he used to have.
But he's not getting in trouble with all the chicks and not getting arrested.
Well, you know, his wife got the drugs in the mail, and everybody says she only got it from him because she's only, like, what, 95 pounds. So it was doubtful that she was trying to pump up.
I don't know.
Well, yeah. I'm glad I called in. You know, what is the show going to be without the grandchild? I mean, come on, you know. So it's like I had to call in. And
this is about the Super Bowl today. We're not going any further than today.
Yep.
Just having some fun. Just relaxing, enjoying it. Going to have some cigars.
You know, and I got Trevor. You know, I got Trevor's back and everything. But you know what? I'm in this because I
sure.
I just love this show. I just love everything about it. I love being on the air, and I love, you know, I, Love everybody.
Well, we love Trevor,
that's
too.
That's my heart.
Yes. Hey, Trevor called me and said he didn't want to do the show today.
Oh.
That's all right. Hey, and we're going to be back with more right after this. We're going to be talking about who spends the most on the Super Bowl and some exciting news about KCAA.
Yes.
A big change happening.
Great. Yes. I'm glad. I'm looking forward to it. Like I said, I'll be back in my chair in a couple of weeks.
All right. Thanks a lot. KCAA 1050 AM, 106.5 FM. Take it away, Joe.
We'll be back after this message.
Joe's, I should say.
Oh.
Hey guys, Pat Matthews here to tell you about the newest and best way to sell products online. It's buysellmakeoffer.com, an enormously revolutionary way to sell your stuff online. It's time to clean out the garage, your old golf clubs, sports equipment, tools, and yes, even your car. Forget about the way the other guys have taken more than their share from you when the sales were finalized. Look, it's happened to me over and over and over. Then I found buysellmakeoffer.com. They will never charge you item fees. Just go there right now to sign up and load all your stuff to our server to sell. This is not an auction site. Sell your car, sell your home. Realtor, sign up now. Just use our resources along with Skype and videos, then add your creativity to sell your items quickly and with no fees. Go right now to buysellmakeoffer.com and sign up. The excitement is building. I've signed up to sell my stuff with buysellmakeoffer.com. You should too. Buysellmakeoffer.com. Is your radio station dull and boring, like most corporate-owned stations on the dial? Then it's time to tune to KCAA 1050 AM. It will blow your mind, and maybe expand it, too. KCAA is your independently-owned go-to station in the Inland Empire. It's a veritable cornucopia of crazy, an assemblage of awesome, and cool, and it's a little weird, too. KCAA pumps out more local and national radio each week than most major networks while offering CNBC business news headlines during the week and NBC sports news on weekends. KCAA is unique, interesting, quirky, and sometimes outlandishly crazy, which adds up to a high volume of awesome. And for you audiophiles, KCAA delivers FM sound quality to our transmitter, which is why KCAA is the best-sounding AM station on the dial. So make your day with KCAA. And find us online at kcaaradio.com. KCAA, the station that leaves no listener behind.
What have I learned so far? Well, I've learned there's no one right path for everyone. I've learned that without my high school diploma, I can only do so much. My options were limited, very limited. I found a free personalized learning program with Learn for Life that has a flexible schedule so I can keep my job while earning my high school diploma. I found a new career with training opportunities that would jumpstart my future. What have I learned so far? I've learned that I could change my life.
Are you 14 to 19 years old and looking for a free high school diploma program with flexible meeting times? This program allows you to keep your job or important family responsibilities while earning your high school diploma. If you've fallen behind on credits or dropped out of school completely, get back on track with free tutoring, a caring faculty, and one-on-one attention. For more information on how to reach your graduation goal, visit learnforlife.org. That's L-E-A-R-N, the number 4, L-I-F-E, .org. Or enroll today by calling 877-360-LEARN. That's 877-360-LEARN.
Empire Talks Back.
The attitude that, well, the little guy cannot win, seems to prevail despite the fact that over time we've seen that the little guy, if he is persistent, he becomes the big guy.
Empire Talks Back.
Well, it's because maybe people figure out a little knowledge is like smoke. It leads to the fire.
Empire Talks Back.
I think this drive for equality, this drive for justice, is gathering steam as opposed to fading out. I think more and more people realize the importance of the freedoms that America represents.
Empire Talks Back with Wallace Allen and friends, Sunday mornings at 10 a.m. on AM 1050 KCAA. But now it seems like things
are You're listening to KCAA, your good neighbor along the way.
Isn't this great sports music?
Oh, yeah, it's a Six Flags theme.
Is it? No, it's not.
Yeah, from a couple of years ago. That little old guy that used to dance to the commercial?
No, it's very similar music, though. Oh. This is Lou Bega.
Sounds like it.
Yeah.
But KCAA leaving no
listeners. By the way, the intro, this is the Super Bowl before the Super Bowl party.
Right.
With
for those of you who...
Joe and Mark.
Right. If you think that the Super Bowl pregame shows get earlier and earlier, it's only Friday, and here we are.
Yes, this is real pre.
Right. But KCAA is known for not leaving any listeners behind, and I have a story about that.
You know, we have to be careful how we say that. KCAA, the station that leaves no listener
behind.
But if you make listeners plural, it's KCAA, the station that leaves no listeners behind. Speaking of behind.
There's a 25-year-old Australia man who has done what everybody's done at the corporate Christmas party, one year or another, when you drank a little bit and decided, I'm going to sit on the copy machine.
I found butt prints on our copy machine after the Christmas party.
Not mine.
I didn't want to know.
No.
I think they were Trevor's.
He's making Valentine cards out of these cheeky presentations.
Some cards are bigger than others.
Yeah. Well,
kind of a hairy experience for some.
No doubt. He's planning on making a big booty full of money.
That's the Magic Mountain theme. Thank you, Joe.
Yeah.
That's the difference.
Ah, okay. And we still need the little old guy with the bald hair and the glasses doing his dance.
Mike Sedbury, can you come up here, please? Mike Sedbury, we'd like you to do a dance for us.
Yeah.
Get Mike and we'll have a dance here.
Yeah.
Mike could do it, too.
Okay, that is. But you see how similar they are.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Okay.
But Six Flags doesn't advertise out here, so the heck with them. He's making...
He's coming. All right, I want the music back. I want Mike back here. The listeners can't see this, but on YouTube, this will challenge you to...
Yeah, the same people that can see the cigars and see my Cleveland Browns ugly sweater.
Uh-huh.
For those of you, if you want to see what
right
things
behind
look
here,
like...
This is our traffic guy, Mike Sedbury. Right. Listeners can't see him, but...
Tell them the website.
The website
they can
is kcaaradio.com. Go to it right now. kcaaradio.com. Okay, Mike. There you go, Mike. Hey, Larry Bud Melvin, you got nothing on, Mike.
Told you pregame activities were starting already.
Thank you, Mike. High five. Okay. We're having too much fun, but this is what the Super Bowl party's about.
Yeah, exactly. So, halftime show, Coldplay. Can you name a song by Coldplay? I can't.
Can you name a song by Coldplay? I don't know. We got Trevor Gardner. We're giving him one more chance. Can you name a song by Coldplay? Can you name a song by Coldplay?
Hello?
Hey, they're not even talking. Hello.
Hello.
Trevor Gardner.
Oh, no. I've got an angry Lyle here, but I'm not sure what's going down.
That's okay. That means you're not
we
paying
have a,
attention.
We have a quiz for you. We have a quiz.
Lyle, yeah. Calm down.
All right. Okay. They're done.
That was fun. Can you name a song by Coldplay? I don't know what they've done.
Mess.
I know Beyonce, who's also part of the halftime show. Thank you. Beyonce did one about putting a ring on her finger, but I don't know the song.
No, that was Beyonce. Yeah,
that was Beyonce. And now I understand that Bruno Mars is supposed to show
up.
There we go.
Joe Pagano is so on it.
Yeah.
This is Coldplay.
This is Coldplay?
Yes. You've heard this before.
I've heard the instrumental version. Is there words to it?
Yes. But anyway, this is a song. Everybody knows it.
I thought Coldplay was the group at the beginning of the Simpsons movie, but I've been told I was wrong.
Okay. So, we've been down that road.
Okay.
Trevor, go home. Relax. Take the Friday off.
Yeah.
Get a life.
The only song that I know, Bruno Mars is supposed to make an appearance, and if he does Uptown Funk, that'll be fun because I like it. My wife hates it, so she'll turn the TV off, and we'll probably switch over and watch the Puppy Bowl or the Kitty Bowl, whatever one the Animal Planet channel is doing.
Lots of people are going to be celebrating the Super Bowl,
yep.
And one of the biggest people to spend the most money, they're saying, is
bigger
not
than you.
Baby boomers, like I was referring to,
right.
Not me, you know, the chips and the dip.
Yep.
It's millennials. They'll spend the most for the Super Bowl. The Super Bowl is just a reason to party. We all know that. And no one is partying harder than millennials. From chips and dip to chicken wings to TVs, millennials, specifically those ages 25 to 34, plan to outspend every other single group on Super Bowl Sunday. And this is from the National Retail Federation. Mm-hmm. They'll probably, on average, spend $140 each.
Wow.
$140 each, these millennials.
That's not counting the buying into the pool.
Well, because they're on their cell phones. They can just go click, click, spend, spend, click, spend, you know.
Right.
You know, click on this snack and have it delivered.
All the decorations.
Yeah. When they're asked about the most important part of the Super Bowl, more than half of millennials say they watch in order to catch the halftime show, which you were talking about.
Right.
And review all the commercials.
Yeah. The commercials, by some accounts, outweigh the game. And I think that's a shame. I have often said the AFC-NFC championships, which we had 2 weeks ago, are better football than the Super Bowl because the pageantry and the hoopla and all the distractions are not there. They come to play football.
Right.
And if you're a fan, that's the game to watch.
But the commercials are so good. And there's one by Doritos. And you got to catch the Doritos commercial.
Tell me why we should catch the Doritos commercial.
Well, if you are from Redlands and you've ever shopped at my most favorite supermarket in the whole world.
You buy your lottery tickets there.
Well, I don't buy a lot of tickets, but it's a favorite store. I love to go there and buy their stuff, and they got great food, prepared food. They, you know, really good. It's called Girard's.
Okay.
And it's on the corner of Center and, I'm thinking, Cypress.
Okay.
Center and Cypress, a great store. It's an old-fashioned kind of grocery store. You get that feeling like you're back into the, you know, 60s and 70s at the old supermarket.
Mom and pop.
Yeah, it's a nice medium size. It's not too big. They've got nice selections of products. Lots of good things. But the one thing about the Super Bowl commercial is they filmed it at Girard's.
Right. Well, that's Doritos has a contest every year for people. They you make a commercial, you submit it to them, and they buy the rights. You make a bag full of money on
and
this.
And people have already seen this commercial, a lot of people. It's the commercial where the dogs are trying to get into the supermarket to get the Doritos.
Right.
And they can't, and finally one on top of each other and put an overcoat on, and they walk in and they get the Doritos.
Yeah.
It's a cute commercial. I love it. That commercial, Redlands Born.
Yep.
Redlands Born. We got a couple lines going here still. I don't know who they are. But, gosh, we'll put them on just for a second just to blast them off again.
Yeah.
Line one, who are we speaking with? Hello.
Hello.
Yes. Can I help you?
My name's Loretta.
Hello, Loretta.
Hi, Loretta. How are you?
I'm doing just fine. I just have a question for you guys.
Sure.
Do you think that what happened to Janet Jackson during the Super Bowl is going to change life forever?
Yep.
It certainly helped sell Velcro.
Yeah, it did. And it also dropped a bomb on MTV because they had been contracted to produce Super Bowl halftime shows until that one. Do you know who it was that pulled the top off of Janet Jackson?
Right, right.
You know who pulled it? Justin Timberlake.
Malfunction. How do you prove that one?
Justin Timberlake, yanked her top and it came off. And that next week they said, we're not using MTV to produce these shows anymore. We'll do somebody else.
Oh, I see that. And can I ask you another question?
Yes, you may.
What was your favorite commercial of all time?
My favorite commercial of all time was... It was one that I did back in about 1995. It was what we call a per inquiry. You're supposed to call this number right away, and if they get phone calls, they pay for the commercial. Well, they paid me in advance, so I didn't really care one way or another.
Yeah.
That was my favorite commercial.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. You guys are doing a great job. Talk to you soon.
Thank
Bye.
You very much.
Thank you, my dear.
Thank you very much.
Yep.
So, you know, moving on here to something that's really some newsworthy stuff is what we're doing here at KCA. A big change is coming.
Yes.
One of the best ever is coming to our airwaves.
We have been proud of a number of the people. Well, we like a number of the people that we've had on. We've, you know, Don Imus is on a regular basis and a few others. We have Stephanie Miller on now in the afternoons. But this is big.
This is big. First of all, this gentleman was on 1090.
Right.
XERT,
mm-hmm.
And it was down below the border.
Mexican station, 100,000 watts. No American AM station can have that much power.
In the 60s and 70s and into the 80s. And he was, you could drive from New York to Los Angeles and not lose the radio station.
Legend has it some people that couldn't quite pick it up would drive up to the top of a mountain. So that they could pick up, and they'd sit there in the car all night just to listen to the show.
If birds flew by the tower... They'd get fried.
Yeah.
There was so much juice coming out of those towers.
Yeah.
Somehow or other, there was a treaty. 1090 is still on the air down in Los Angeles, but they're real, real, real small now.
Now I'll give you the first hint. If you saw the movie American Graffiti, you saw him in action.
And I'm not going to announce him. I'm going to play him. We're going to play a little bit of the Wolfman. Oh!
So what?
Oh, we're going to play a little bit.
Wolverine? It's not Hugh Jackson.
No, it's not Hugh Jackson. No. And then we're going to come back. Take it away, Joe Pagano.
It's KRLA's 4th of July weekend with Richie Dolly.
Ladies and gentlemen, Wolfman Jack.
This is the heart and soul of rock and roll with Wolfman Jack on KRLA, Pasadena.
Wolfman Jack.
All right. I say everybody want to dance, just get up and get out of your cars. You there in the kitchen dancing around, I want you to dance with us now. We got little Richard, and he gonna blow the walls down with Lucille.
KRLA.
Yes, I know you want to rock and roll. I know you need a little soul. Come on, baby. ZZ Top.
I'm in love.
Hello?
I like your body. I like your body.
Don't I have you down for Tuesday at 9 o'clock?
This is the heart and soul of rock and roll with Wolfman Jack on KRLA, Pasadena.
Tonight from 10 till 2 in the morning, Huggy Boy has just gotten back from the racetrack, by the way, and he's going to be with us right here on the heart and soul of rock and roll KRLA. That's 10 to 2 this morning. I'm looking forward to seeing that old good-looking son of a gun. You know what I mean? That's how we're going to play this for him. Here's the Four Seasons and Sherry Baby. All this July 4th weekend, it's an oldies but goodies.
All right. Yeah. You know it now. Wolfman Jack.
Wolfman Jack is coming. In fact, I'll tell you something.
Jack is back.
They may know that there was a secret sneak presentation of his Christmas special. We don't talk about that. If you heard it, you heard it. If you didn't hear it, it didn't happen. Yeah. Wolfman Jack will be returning to the airwaves, the lost tapes of the Wolfman.
Digitally remastered.
Right.
So they sound spectacular.
And you will hear them here.
We didn't bring Wolfman back to life. But
no.
Just like Antenna TV on Channel 5.2 and Antenna TV, over the air, you can watch this. The Johnny Carson Show is on every night of the week.
Right.
On 8 o'clock and at midnight now. It's great to watch the king of late night. He was truly the master.
Yeah.
I got to tell you. On that channel, you can watch Johnny Cash, Carson twice, George Burns, and Jack Benny do their shows.
Yeah.
It's really kind of a cool channel. But anyway, we are so happy. Wolfman Jack will be here Friday and Saturday nights from when?
From midnight until 5 a.m.
And we just got a sponsor.
Yep.
And that's some news that if our owner is listening, he's going to be jumping up and down. So
you guys raised some money doing this
we
finally?
We did. We already raised some money doing
it. Hey.
That's right. So we are very, 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 very happy about that. We got lots of good things happening on the weekend.
Yes.
And some new shows.
Yep.
Starting this weekend at midnight.
Right.
Tell us all about it.
That would be the Sounds of Sinatra. If you like those tunes that everybody likes. You know what amazes me about Frank Sinatra and his music? They put out periodically a new bundle of greatest hits. And iTunes, the Apple program where you download them for your iPod, they go to number one. The album, the Frank Sinatra albums, past Coldplay, past Beyonce, past Bruno Mars, Sinatra hits number one on downloads. This isn't, you know, walking into the record store who sold the most vinyl. This is people that all they have to do is push a button and get it, and they're doing it. Frank is alive. Mm-hmm. Him and the pack. Well, you see the Morongo Casino commercials where they do that imitation of the Rat Pack. Mm-hmm. There's a Sinatra-type guy in a pork pie hat, and there's a black guy, kind of the Sammy Davis Jr. type, and there's an Italian kind of Dean Martin type, and they're in black and white just to add to the effect. you say what you want to. The recording of Come Fly With Me or Young at Heart is as good today as it was 50 years ago.
Now, we also we're replacing Denny Farrell at midnight with him from Chicago. But now we're bringing on another guy from Chicago.
And that is?
John Pizzarelli.
No, he's in New York.
Is he in New York?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, geez. Pardon me. I thought I...
Radio Deluxe, live from Park Avenue in downtown Manhattan.
Oh, okay. I got my Chicago and New York confused.
They look a lot alike, especially after about your third or fourth straight shot of whiskey.
Hey, speaking of which, maybe we should just blow Trevor off again.
Yeah.
Trevor, he hung up.
That's good.
Oh, we were just going to put him on. No, there's two lines going.
Yeah.
Who knows what those could be?
Well,
let's play... Line roulette, ladies and gentlemen, on line one, we have, hello, ladies and gentlemen, line one, go for it. Hello.
Nathan Henry, I just want you to know the weather is going to be outrageous this weekend for the Super Bowl.
Yes, it is going to be wonderful, Hennington.
Yes.
Can you tell us what it's going to be like at the beach?
El Nino, huh?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, it's going to be wonderful weather. It already is.
Easily mid-70s along the beach, so you can watch the Super Bowl at the beach, and the waves are pretty good, too.
85 degrees here in the Inland Empire over the weekend.
Yeah.
Awesome. We got Santa Ana winds offshore right now, man. This is great.
Yeah.
What's the surf like right now?
Well, the surf actually was really good this morning. It's dropping off a little bit, like 3 to 6 feet, a couple 7-foot faces in Huntington Beach, mainly the west-facing areas.
Mm-hmm.
Very, very cool. Huntington, thanks for that surf report. We're glad you called in. It's good to hear your voice on the air again. I've been missing you.
So. This is an imposter, by the way.
It is? Oh, it is.
Probably.
Yeah, it's good. Hey, talk to you later, okay?
Yeah,
good.
It's not an imposter. It's Hurricane Harry.
Yeah.
We know your voice anywhere. And then next we have... Who do we have?
Hello
line
there.
Two. Do, 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 do,
hello?
Do, do,
are you
hello?
There?
Hello, are you there?
Am I on the air?
I can't hear you. Oh, I can't hear you. Oh, there must be something wrong with our cell phone, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, maybe we should start charging for phone calls.
Yes. I'm sorry, Joe.
Yeah. So anyhow, never let it be said that night times are not the right times on KCAA.
That's right.
Because we've got some premier entertainment, whether it's Sid Mark's Sinatra shows or the Wolfman, as alive as we can get him.
Tommy Hawkins. A great jazz show.
Right.
A great jazz show from 8 until 10.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just one of the finest. And being on 106.5 FM, you listen to that jazz on FM especially.
Right.
Whoa, it sounds good. And then, you know, we can't forget that at 6 p.m. we have Switch Reels. That's kind of a nice show. She plays some jazz,
mm-hmm.
and she plays a lot of gospel.
Oh.
Gospel is just fun music.
Yeah.
Give me that old-time religion. Give me that.
I'll tell you a bit of trivia. For those of people who live in Fontana and they know their mayor, Aquanetta Warren,
right.
And I made the same mistake a lot of people made. I thought Aquanetta Warren was named after a hairspray, and I apologize. I was wrong. Apparently, it turns out there was a classic gospel. This is serious. There was a classic gospel singer whose name was Aquanetta, and the mayor of Fontana is named for her.
Aquanetta, yes.
Yeah.
And she doesn't come in a can, and she doesn't.
No, she was a great gospel singer from years ago.
She's not up for election, so I can say she's a great lady.
Yeah,
and she really is.
You can,
we got the Wolfman back song. We're going to do that on the way out of the show.
Yes,
we're going to do that on the way out of the show. First of all, though, every third Thursday in San Bernardino, we have the Food Truck Fest.
Right, just across the street from us.
And if you want to pay $10 for a hamburger,
mm-hmm.
hey, that's the place to go.
Yeah.
That's the downside of it.
Most of the trucks, the mobile food stands, they come in from L.A. and they charge L.A. prices.
Right.
But the fact that they're there, the fact that there's a sense of community, the fact that there are people gathering together.
I didn't say there weren't good hamburgers. I just said,
oh, hey, for $10, they better be a good hamburger.
Really a good hamburger.
Yeah.
You really got to love those hamburgers. But right next door,
mm-hmm.
but they do this every week, and they just, we saw them over there. This next, there's a big stage
right.
at Courtney Street.
Mm-hmm.
And right next door to this is this little fair. Festival. It's the farmer's market.
Kind of an adjacent
right,
festival.
Right. And every Thursday from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m., there's the San Bernardino Farm Share and Market at Court Street Square.
Right.
We don't want to overlook that. It's a good group of people. They have Pampered Chef, Sonia's Daughter, Self Defense, Wilson and Company. Wilson and Company has some great stuff.
Yeah, this is the amazing thing. They're all Mark's friends.
Well, I used to run farmers markets. That's why. I know all these people.
Yeah.
Miss Cindy's Shop, the Tea Lightful Teas, Nana's Blankets and Gifts, Avon, Origami, Owl, Young Creel, and the Vernal Dental Group. There's all kinds of food. It is a great, great, great thing. They've got tacos, burritos, tortas, smoke them if you've got them, barbecue. And, the food is pretty good, and it's pretty well decently priced.
I was impressed.
And it all goes to the patrons of the Roosevelt Bowl.
Yeah.
which is an organization, a nonprofit organization that I helped start years ago.
That's the one out by Fiscalini Field, right?
That's right. The patrons of the Roosevelt Bowl. The Roosevelt Bowl, a lot of people know it as the Paris Hill Bowl,
yeah,
is an 1,800-seat amphitheater. It was built in the WPA area, yeah, era, and it was built at the same time about the plunge. The Paris Hill Plunge was built. This mm-hmm. is now called the Jerry Lewis Family Fun Center.
Okay.
After Congressman Jerry Lewis.
Ah.
Not the funny Jerry Lewis, the congressman. But
I've always had more laughs with Congressman Jerry Lewis.
I actually know him, too. Yep. He served on the school board with my aunt.
I served on jury duty once, and when I was sitting in the pool waiting in that thing in the morning, I turned to the next, and I was sitting next to Jerry Lewis. I said, "You can't get out of jury duty?" He said, "Nope."
It was Jerry duty. Yeah. Anyway, this is the San Bernardino's Downtown Farm Share and Market at Court Street Square, Thursdays from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Lots of great stuff, lots of great food. Go down there, support them. KCA is down there, too.
Yeah.
And we are glad to help support them and make that announcement. It's a very, very important cause. This outdoor amphitheater called the Roosevelt Theater seats 1,800 people. It is where they have Junior University every year, yeah, which is just a great organization. It's a summer stock music festival for kids. They have about 150 kids. They've been doing this for over 40 years.
I've seen a couple of the shows. Yeah. They write their own music.
Well, it's William R. Dixon, yeah, rest his soul, wrote these stuff.
And yeah.
He adapted them from, you know, lots of great things from Disney and stuff like that.
Yeah.
It really is a neat, neat thing to go see. And that's in San Bernardino. It's one of the great things about San Bernardino. That amphitheater really needs a lot of help. And they've been working on it for a few years. And I really, really want you to go down there. If you're downtown San Bernardino, you're working in downtown San Bernardino, you know, skip Carl's that day, skip Del Taco that day, McDonald's. Those are great places. Yeah, they got great deals. Go to this farm share market.
By the way, there's a reason why whenever we talk about the live performances up there, I always call it Fiscalini Field instead of Paris Hill. Because, do you remember 1988, the original local minor league team, the San Bernardino Spirit?
Yep.
Do you know who the original stadium announcer was?
Joe Lyons, ladies and gentlemen. Da, da,
thank
da, da,
you.
Da. That's
thank
why
you.
His name sounds familiar.
Thank
hey,
you very
couple
much.
Other things I want to do. A shout out to Richardson Prep High Middle School.
Okay.
Do you remember watching them perform when we were there the last time?
Oh, yeah.
They were great. This is a junior high school team. Peter Lamas is the teacher. Peter does an outstanding job with this group. Kudos to them. Want to give them a high five and
they really did. They were
together. Excellence.
They were tight.
They were excellent. They were tight. They were great. They had singers. They had dancers. The band was performing. The kids were loving it, and they were out here in the community. That's what it's all about.
And we were eating $10 hamburgers.
And Super Bowl Sunday and happy hour, continuing the tradition here. We love it here at KCA. We're just about ready to wrap things up a little bit. We got 2 or 3 minutes. Joe, do you have anything you want to shout out to?
I'm taking my cigars home with me.
Yeah, he didn't share one with me today.
I told you you could have one. You didn't move
on. Oh, okay. I'm selecting a cigar here. The best one, right? I got the best one. What is this one? That's the Gurkha.
They're all Gurkhas.
They're all Gurkhas.
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't think that one has a particular name to it.
I will enjoy that Super Bowl Sunday.
That's a dark one.
Yeah. Hey, coming up, we've got the Stephanie Miller Show, one of our brand new shows. Later on this afternoon, we have Mo Ansari.
Mm-hmm.
And the...
Well, Amo!
No.
Different Mo.
Anyway, the financial stock report.
Yeah.
And tonight we've got all kinds of fun stuff. And over the weekend, lots of great music.
Yep. Right.
Wolfman Jack is coming.
Clap for the Wolfman.
Clap for the Wolfman. That's what we're listening to right now, right? KCA 1050 AM and 106.5 FM. Wolfman Jack coming. Take care. Happy Super Bowl. Go Broncos.
Go Cleveland. Hey, little girl, was it so long ago? We'd take a walk just to be alone. And hey, little girl, if it should rain or snow, remember where we would go. Did you boogie with your baby in the back row of the movie show? And did you boogie there because you had nowhere else that you could go? Trouble to you.
don't be afraid. You heard what I said. Let the cold wind blow. Let him blow, let him blow. From the east to the west, I love you the best. Let the cold wind blow.
This is KCAA Loma Linda. CNBC News is next. Brought to you by BuySellMakeOffer.com. Go there now and join the thousands who have already signed up for a new and exciting way to buy and sell online. Launching January 15th.
I'm Tom Busby, CNBC Radio. Stocks took a real tumble today following some bad news and some good news in the January jobs report. At the close, the Dow 211 points lower and a big sell-off in tech stocks sending the NASDAQ down 146. Now, last month, 151,000 jobs were added to the economy, which was far less than economists expected. But the nation's unemployment rate down one notch to an 8-year low, just 4.9%, and wages were actually higher. The U.S. trade deficit grew in December, exports dipped, and the U.S. imported more cheaper foreign-made cars and oil. Americans borrowed a lot more money in December, pushing total consumer debt to more than $3.5 trillion, a new record. The big drivers that month, more student loans and credit card debt. And Twitter, shutting down 125,000 accounts it says are linked to terror groups, including ISIS, and it's using spam-fighting technology to look for more. Tom Busby, CNBC.
Ace has the lighting options you want and the answers you need. Right now, 4 packs of Fight.